Polynomials part 2. Okay. So we are going to see value of polynomial. What is value of polynomial? If P of x is a polynomial in x, you take any polynomial in x, and if k is any real number, k is any real number, then the real number obtained by replacing x by k. In place of x, you have to replace k. Okay, then this P of x is called value of polynomial at x is equal to k. Clear? When you replace x by k, you will get P of k. You will get P of k. So whatever getting P of k, the value we will get, that value is called value of polynomial. Clear? Value of polynomial. And it is denoted by P of k, you see. P of k, okay, P of k, you will get one answer, okay, that value is called value of the polynomial P of x, okay. Now we will see example. P of x you take it as x squared plus x minus 1, okay. Put x is equal to minus 1. Put x is equal to minus 1. So, in place of x, I am putting x is equal to minus 1. So, what will happen? Minus 1, the whole square, minus 1, minus 1. Okay. Just to replace, in place of x, you put minus 1. Okay. Now, simplify. Therefore, P of minus 1 equal to minus 1 square is minus 1 into minus 1, that is plus 1. Plus into minus, minus 1. Again, minus 1. Here you see 1 plus 1 minus get cancelled. That means minus 1. Therefore, minus 1 is the value of P of x. Okay. Therefore, minus 1 is value of P of x. At x is equal to minus 1. At x is equal to minus 1. When you put x is equal to minus 1, you are getting the value of the polynomial, that is minus 1. So minus 1 is the value of P of x at x is equal to minus 1. Okay, we will see one more example. P of x equal to x squared minus x squared plus 4 you take, x squared plus 4. Okay. So put x is equal to 2. Put x is equal to 2. What happened? P of 2 equal to 2 squared plus 4. So P of 2 equal to 4 plus 4. So that is 8. So 8 is value of 4. 8 is value of the polynomial, polynomial P of x at x is equal to 2. 8 is value of polynomial, this polynomial, clear, value of polynomial at x is equal to 2. At x is equal to 2. Okay. So, like this, what we can do so many examples. Clear? Okay. You try to understand what is value of polynomial. Clear? Suppose when the value is 0, sometime you may get 0 also. When the value is 0, there you will get 0 of polynomial. So next we are going to see zeros of polynomial. Okay. So next we will see zeros of a polynomial. Zeros of a polynomial. A real number k is said to be a zero of a polynomial P of x if P of k equal to 0. So when you replace the x by k, then if you get the value of that polynomial is 0, means okay, this k is called zero of a polynomial. Zero of a polynomial. Clear? Understand? So, for example, you see, P of x is equal to x squared minus 4. P of x is equal to x squared minus 4. Now, I am putting x is 2. Put x is 2 means what will happen? P of 2 is equal to 2 squared minus 4. 2 squared
square is what? 4 minus 4, 0. So you are getting P of 2 is 0. That means this 2 is 0 of P of X. 2 is 0 of P of X. Or we can say root of the polynomial. Clear? You can say root 2. 0 or root also we can say. Okay. In your syllabus it is given 0. In higher class you will study root of the polynomial. Clear? Now you remember 0. Clear? It is 0 of P of X. When 0 of P of X means? When you will get P of 2 equal to 0. Clear? When P of 2 equal to 0, then you can say 2 is 0 of P of X. Understand? You should not confuse that 0 polynomial. Okay, 0 of the polynomial. 0 polynomials, the whole polynomial equal to 0. Clear? That is 0 polynomial. Understand? But here 0 of the polynomial. Okay, 0 polynomial is totally different from 0 of polynomial P of X. Right? Here 2 is 0 of P of X. Like that you put X is equal to minus 2. What will happen? Put X is equal to minus 2. P of minus 2 is equal to minus 2 the whole squared minus 4. Always put the value in the bracket. Put the value in the bracket. You see, I am replacing the X. Okay, using bracket. Okay, so that that minus 2 whole squared. What is the meaning of minus 2 whole square? Minus 2 is multiplied by 2 times. Minus 2 multiplied by 2 times. Here minus 2 into minus 2. Plus 4. Again plus 4. Clear? So 4 minus 4, 0. Again getting 0. So P of minus 2 equal to 0 means, now what you can say? Minus 2 is also 0 of P of X. Minus 2 is also 0 of P of X. Minus 2 is also 0 of P of X. Understand? So you are getting 2 0 of this polynomial. You are getting what? 2 zeros. Since it is a quadratic polynomial whose degree is 2, definitely you have 2 zeros. Definitely you have 2 zeros. Clear? So that 2 zeros are, one is 2, another one is minus 2. Clear? So 2 and minus 2 are 2 zeros. 2 zeros of P of X. 2 zeros of P of X. Understand? So like this, so many problems you can do. One more we will see. P of X equal to X squared plus X minus 1. You take. Put X is equal to 2. Put X is equal to 2. What will happen is P of 2 equal to, just to replace, 2 squared plus 2 minus 1. So 4 plus 2 minus 1. So 6 minus 1. That is 5. 5 is not equal to 0. 5 is not equal to 0. Therefore, Therefore, 2 is not a 0. 2 is not a 0 of P of X. Okay, P of, when you put X value 2, you should get 0. Then only what, this 2 will become a 0. Otherwise 2 is not a 0. Otherwise 2 is not a 0 of P of X. Clear now? So next we will see the problems. Exercise 2.2, first two problems. Find the value of the polynomial 5 of x minus 4 x squared plus 3 at x is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 1, x is equal to 2. You have to find out. Clear? Further, first what you have to do is the given polynomial, this is given polynomial, you have to name it as P of x. You have to name it as P of x. So, let P of X equal to 5X minus 4X squared plus 3. Name it. Clear? Now put this X is equal to 0 here. Clear? Put X is equal to 0. That is first problem. So P of 0 you will get. P of 0 is equal to 5 into 0 minus 4 into 0 squared plus 3. So 5 into 0, 0. 0 squared, 0. Then this fully water, 0. So you will get 3, 1. Right? Understand? Therefore, 3 is the value of, 3 is value of P of X at X is equal to 0. 3 is value of P of X at X is equal to 0. Clear? Second one you see. X is equal to minus 1. X is equal to minus 1. Same way, P of X again you take. The same polynomial 3 times you have to find out. Okay? Now here put X is equal to minus 1. We get P of minus 1 equal to 5 into minus 1 minus 4 into minus 1 the whole squared plus 3. You see, put the value in the bracket. That is very important. Always put the value in the bracket. Then only simplification, okay, you will do correctly. So 5 into minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 square is 1. So 1 into minus 4 minus 4 plus 3. So what you will get? Minus 9 plus 3, that is minus 6. Minus 6. Therefore minus 6 is the value of P of X at X is equal to minus 1. You have to write this final answer. Clear? Minus 6 is the value of P of X at X is equal to minus 1. Third one also you see. P of X, same way put 5X minus 4X squared plus 3. So put X is equal to 2. Put X is equal to 2. The same polynomial. Third one, X is equal to 2 you have to do. That means P of 2 equal to 5 into 2 minus 4 into 2 squared plus 3. So what you will get is 10 minus 4 into 4, 16 plus 3. So here 10 minus 16 is minus 6 plus 3. So that is minus 3. Therefore minus 3 is value of polynomial P of X at X is equal to 2. At X is equal to 2. Okay. You see, next problem, find P of 0, P of 1 and P of 2 for each of the following polynomials. P of Y given. First given P of Y equal to Y squared minus Y plus 1. So this is polynomial in Y. Previous problem we have seen what polynomial in X. This one polynomial in Y. So here you have to take Y equal to 0. If you put Y equal to 0, you will get P of 0. You should put Y equal to 0. Okay. Put Y equal to 0 means you will get P of 0. Okay. So P of 0 equal to 0 the whole square minus 0 plus 1. That means this will be 0 only. So ignore. So you will get 1 only. Okay. So 1 is the value of polynomial at P of 0. X is equal to, Y equal to 0. Clear? Y equal to 0. Right? Therefore, 1 is value of polynomial. 1 is value of P of 0 also you can write. Or P of Y if you write means at Y equal to 0. Like this you have to write. At Y equal to 0. So second one we have to find out about P of 1. P of 1 we have to find out. So what you have to do? P of Y, what is given? Write P of Y. P of Y equal to Y square minus Y plus 1. So to get P of 1 means you put Y equal to 1. Put Y equal to 1. That means P of 1 equal to 1 the whole square minus 1 plus 1. That means 1 minus 1 plus 1. So minus 1 plus 1 cancel. So plus 1. So 1 is value of P of Y. 1 is value of P of 1. Right. Then third, P of 2 you have to find out. Same polynomial, P of 2 you have to find out. Right? P of 2. So, P of y is what is given? P of y. Y square minus y plus 1. Right? Now, P of 2 find out. To get P of 2 means put y equal to 2. Put y equal to 2. So, P of 2 equal to 2 the whole square minus 2 plus 1. Okay? So, 2 the whole square minus 4 minus 2 plus 1. That means 2 plus 1 is 3. 2 plus 1 is 3. So, 3 is value of P of 2. Okay? Or 3 is value of P of y at y equal to 2 you can write. Or directly P of 2 also you can write. Understand? Okay? So, first to find out P of 0. P of 0 means you replace by x 0 means P of 0 equal to 0 minus 1, 0 plus 1. So, minus 1 into plus 1. Minus 1 into plus 1. That is minus 1. Therefore, P of 0 we got minus 1. Okay? Same way, 1 you put P of 1 means one minus 1, 1 plus 1, that means what? 0 into 2, that is what? 0. So, P of 1 is 0 we got it. Then P of 2 you put in this, P of 2. So, P of 2 you put, in place of x put 2, that means 2 minus 1 into 2 plus 1. So, 2 minus 1 is 2 into 3. Or 2 minus 1 is 1, 2 minus 1 is 1. Next we will find out P of 2. Okay, P of 2. So just to replace in place of x 2 you put 2 minus 1, 2 plus 1, right? So 2 minus 1 is 1, that is 3. So 1 into 3, 3. That's all. Clear? So these values what easily we can get this time by putting that value in the polynomial, easily we will get the value of the polynomial. Clear? You see, next problem, verify whether the indicated numbers are zeros of the polynomial corresponding to them in the following cases. That means you have to, what the given this x is, clear, whether zero or not, you have to find out. For that, what you have to do is you replace replace x by minus 1 by 3 in the given polynomial. That means x is equal to minus 1 by 3. You just what replace it. That means 3 into minus 1 by 3 plus 1. Here 3 is numerator. Here 3 is denominator. So you can cancel it. Okay. Because in multiplication only it is possible. Here. So minus 1 plus 1. Yes, 0. Therefore P of minus 1 by 3 equal to 0. That means minus 1 by 3 is 0. Minus 1 by 3 is 0 of P of x. Minus 1 by 3 is 0 of P of x. Or you can say minus 1 by 3 is root of P of x. Clear? You see, second problem here, x is 4 by 5 is given. Okay. So we have to check whether the 4 by 5 is 0 or not. We have to check. For that, what you have to do is you put in this. Therefore, P of 4 by 5, you have to find out. 4 by 5 minus 5. Clear? So 5, 5 get cancelled. Therefore, that is equal to 4 minus 5. 4 minus 5 is not equal to 0. Clear? 4 minus 5 is not equal to 0. Because if you put the pi value is 22 by 7 or pi value 3.14 means not equal to 0 only will get. Right? It is clear that not equal to 0. Therefore, 4 by 5 is not 0. Is not a 0. 0 of P of x. Not a 0 of P of x. Clear? You see, in this problem, two values given. Both the value we have to check whether both the values are getting 0 or not. Okay? We have to check. That means first we put x is equal to minus 1. So P of minus 1 find out. So, in place of x, correctly you have to put minus 1 plus 1, then minus 1 minus 2. So, minus 1 plus 1 is 0. This is minus 3. So, 0 into anything 0. Yes, getting. Therefore, my p of minus 1 is 0 means then minus 1 is 0. Minus 1 is 0 of p of x. Clear? Next 2 you have to put. Therefore, find out p of 2. P of 2 equal to what? 2 plus 1 into 2 minus 2. So, 2 plus 1 is what? 3 into 0. Again, 0 coming. Therefore, p of 2 0 means this implies 2 is 0 of, 2 is also 0 of p of x. Okay, therefore both are 0, minus 1 and 2 are 0s of p of x. Right, therefore minus 1 and 2 are 0s of p of x. 0s of p of x. Okay. You see the next problem, 0 is given, x is 0 is given. So just to replace it, p of 0 equal to 0 squared. 0 squared is what? 0. Therefore, 0 you are getting. So p of 0 equal to 0 gives 0 is 0 of p of x. Okay, sometimes 0 is also 0 of p of x. Okay, understand? The concept is what? Whatever value you are putting in the x, you have to get the value of polynomial is 0, then this value will be the 0 of p of x. Clear? Okay. You see here x value given minus m by l. Just to replace it in this polynomial. So p of minus m by l is equal to minus l. In place of x, you have to replace. That means minus m by l plus m. So what you will get here, what L get cancelled, clear? L get cancelled, but minus 1 is there here, okay? So minus 1 into minus M, M plus M. So 2M you will get. 2M you are getting. So it is not equal to 0. It is not equal to 0. Okay, therefore, the minus M by L is not a 0, okay? So it is not equal to 0. Not equal to 0. Therefore, minus m by l is not a 0 of p of x. Not a 0 of p of x. Clear? So next problem, you see the fourth problem. Find the 0 of the polynomial in each of the following cases. The first one, you see p of x equal to x plus 5. P of x equal to x plus 5. So to find out the 0 of the polynomial means whole polynomial you have to make 0. What is 0 polynomial? 0 is 0 polynomial. So here p of x you have to make equal to 0. Therefore this x plus 5 equal to 0. The whole thing, the whole polynomial will be 0, means you can find out 0 of polynomial. Clear? So that is x is equal to what? Minus 5. So minus 5 is 0 of p of x. So simply finding x value, putting the p of x is 0. Clear? Here also p of x equal to 2x plus 5 is given. Whole thing you make 0. That means 2x plus 5 equal to 0. 2x is equal to minus 5. Therefore x is equal to minus 5 by 2. Okay. X is equal to minus 5 by 2. Therefore minus 5 by 2 is 0 of p of x. Okay, you have to find out the 0 of p of x means you have to make 0. Clear? Next problem is p of x equal to 3x given. So you have to make 0 means 3x is equal to 0. So x is equal to 0 by 3. That is 0. X is equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is 0 of. 0 is 0 of p of x. Here, 0 is also one of the root. Okay. See, next problem, p of x is equal to cx plus d given. Okay, how to find out for this 0? Clear? So, what you have to do? This whole thing you make 0. Therefore, cx plus d equal to 0. Therefore, cx is equal to plus d, bring this side minus d. Therefore, x is equal to minus d by c. Therefore, minus d by c is 0 of p of x. Clear?
So I will give same type of problems for you to practice.